Tally Bakery in Kigali, and this is our vlog number 2.
You can get anything at Tally. It's a surprise every time. Your food you order is different sometimes. Sometimes it seems like the coffee's different, but it's always good. So that's why we like it. Thank you. Wow, it's a big one. And they give you a napkin with everything.
They do. This is Kigigutto. It's a fermented milk drink. It's actually one of my favorite things here. It tastes a lot like just like a plain kefir. Yeah, and I think this whole thing is 500 francs, so it's like, less than a dollar. A lot less than a dollar. It's 820 francs to $1, so.
It's cheap. Mm-hmm. It's cheap and it's a whole meal in itself because it fills you up.
Mm. Yeah, and Tally's actually is, I think, our favorite place. In Kigali so far, right? It's cheap, it has a really wide variety of things on their menu, but it's still African food, because there's lots of restaurants here that are Indian food or Mediterranean food and things, and they're so expensive, even though the food is good.
Yeah, we've done some looking around at different restaurants and stuff, and like, there's kind of the small mom and pop style restaurant that usually just has like tea and chapati and samosas, like snacks and tea. Mm-hmm. And then it's like a jump to like a fancy dining sit down restaurant where you're ending up like paying like, you know, maybe $3 or $4 a meal, which is kind of a lot. And then it's kind of hard to find an in-between place where you can still get like food, but you're not gonna like, it'll be like a cheap price and like a simple meal.
Yeah, so we ordered veggie soup and a Rolex, so we'll let you know when those get here. Sometimes it takes a while for food. So we thought we were recording as our food arrived, but turns out we weren't. Our food is here though, and it looks amazing. This is the veggie soup that I got, and it's 1,500 francs, which is very cheap. And here's Paul's food. It's chips and a Rolex, which is that thing right there.
Pretty much just a chapati with an egg, like an omelet, they say, inside of it. Really cheap for some reason, and it's like a kind of filling. And then this is their ketchup, which is like a jello-y, like tangy, just really sweet, I don't even know, jello. So it always comes with this like huge glob of mayonnaise, and it's kind of good to mix them together because then this like kind of adds this creaminess to the, to this tangy, jello-y ketchup, and then you have kind of a, an interesting sauce for your fries.
Ooh, how's that? The soup's always slightly different. Very good today though. It's made of, I think one of the main things in it is, is it moringa or moringa?
Moringa.
It's moringa, and it's like this a green that grows here that supposedly has all kinds of health benefits. I'm not sure, but it tastes really good.
And chips comes with like everything. Mm. Chips or fries is like just a very common sight for like every meal you can ever get. Which is kind of good. That is, you can always munch on them, but sometimes you want like a salad or something. What does that taste like?
Kind of tastes like spinach, a little bit. It smells like it's like salty and it tastes like chicken broth.
I'm getting kind of a clam chowdery, like like a peppery clam chowdery split pea. think we're in a bit of a dry season. It hasn't rained in like 3 weeks, so we have to have water delivered. I think like when this happens, most people have to call a company to bring water. And it can be kind of expensive. But yeah, we're just trying to conserve. We showered with just like a tiny bit of water in our buckets yesterday, and it's not so bad. It can be done, but we're kind of like holding off on laundry and other things like that.
Yeah, because laundry takes like at least 3 buckets of water, and then, yeah, a shower usually takes like 1 bucket, but like you said, we're showering with like this much water, so we're praying for rain.
A lot of carrying water around in Africa. Everybody does it. It's part of daily life. Water's really heavy, but I don't know. It's not so bad.
So, yesterday we started another batch of kombucha. A few weeks ago we tried to grow our own SCOBY with some kombucha that we found in a little shop like right next to the base. And we let it ferment for like 2 weeks, and it grew somewhat of a SCOBY, but we weren't sure.
It grew something.
Yeah, it definitely grew something. And we were afraid to use it to culture our tea, so we actually threw that one out. And then yesterday, a YWAMer from the Eastern Province came for a visit to the base, and she brought us one of her SCOBYs that she uses for her tea. So yesterday we started a new batch, so we'll see how that goes, and next week we'll check up on that.
So we gotta go into town. We're gonna buy some supplies for the speakers we've got coming for the DTS, and we have to buy them juice because every speaker needs juice. It's a thing. But if you ever find yourself in Rwanda, you come to Tally's Cafe. It's really good, and it's really hard to find, but it's worth it. Don't get it. Anyway, yeah. We hope you enjoyed watching us, and we'll keep you updated with all the other weird, fun things that we're doing living in Rwanda.
Yeah, thanks for watching. You can subscribe to our channel and check out our blog at theadventuresofpaulandsue.com.